Hello friends, this is Professor Arjun Chakraborty in New Delhi, India. Actually, day after tomorrow, I'm going to take my international flight Finnair to be in Europe, and my first stop for this 2017 autumn Europe trip will be Vilnius. After that, I will be after Lithuania, I'll be practicing in Bulgaria, in Belarus, in Poland, in Latvia, Estonia, and in different cities of these countries. But today I'm going to talk on what is the significance of a Vedic astrological consultation. As you know, for many years, for almost two decades, I'm giving consultations in different countries and different cities. Sometimes my consultations satisfy me, sometimes being a human, I myself may not be so satisfied with a particular consultation. But thankfully to God, gradually the people who have been interested in my consultations have grown in number, and I have received invitations from different countries for going there and giving trainings and consultations. So friends, Vedic astrology consultation consists of two divisions, broadly two divisions. One is definitely the predictive part and the different kinds of spiritual advices, psychological advices, practical advices, different kinds of advices which a Vedic astrologer is supposed to give to his or her client. The spiritual advices are very important here. For example, in some special cases, I may see that you may be financially profited by some particular activities. But if that is not good for your karma, if that is particularly bad for your karma, for your future, for your mental peace, for your spiritual life, being a Vedic astrologer, I may not advise you that. I may tell you that what sort of actions you have done in your past life, which may be turning out to be detrimental for happiness in this life, and how you can balance that in this life. Well, I must say that the other part of Vedic astrological consultation is, of course, the remedial part. But the remedial part is very important, but at the same time, I would never say that I can like overturn the events in your life, I can make magical changes in your life, because all the changes are definitely possible to be made only by the Almighty, the God. And being a Vedic astrologer, I will act like an advocate who would try to plead for you with your case in the court of the God. So the final decision whether to give you relief or not, that lies in the hands of God. A Vedic astrologer, often you will see Vedic astrologers or any other style of astrologers trying to pretend that they have strange powers, they have occult powers. I would never claim that. I would rather say that I am a very simple person who believes in simple life, simple lifestyle, and spreading the knowledge of Vedic astrology, because Vedic astrology can give us some material relief, some spiritual relief, some relief in personal life. So it is kind of a combination of material life and spiritual life, how we can look after both aspects of our life. So Vedic astrological consultation is very spiritual in nature. And along with that, the different kinds of remedial measures are of course there. They can be in different forms of donations, they can be in different forms of wearing of minerals, wearing of metals, sometimes wearing of some spiritual designs, sometimes they can be chanting of some mantras, sometimes they can be some other kinds of activities which I can see the main horoscope, see the horoscope, and then I can be more specific on that. So I would say a Vedic astrological consultation can help you taking important decisions in your life regarding your personal life, so regarding your professional life, your academic life, your health, what kind of health issues you can be facing in the next 5 or 10 years, what kind of a life partner can be good for you regarding personal life, what kind of people can make good business partners for you, what kind of studies can give you a bright future, what kind of gurus What kind of places are there where you can find spiritual development? What kind of countries can give you happiness, and what kind of countries can actually end up sad, end up making you sad? So all these things are very detailedly discussed in a Vedic astrological consultation, and along with that, definitely a very important part is the remedial parts and how you can develop your spiritual life. That is extremely important. The spiritual aspects, like how we can change our karma. Of course, we cannot change our karma completely. It is not so easy. Karma can be of two kinds. One is fixed and one is not so fixed. So a part of the horoscope is very fixed, and we will have to be ready to accept the consequences of those planetary indications which are fixed. They can be good also, not only bad, they can be good also. So some things I will tell you which you will have to accept, which you will have to adapt to, and which sometimes you can surpass by doing some noble activities. For example, if you have very dangerous indications of accidents or bloodshed, things like that, then why don't you donate some blood every year on a Tuesday specifically, and that may already cause the accident. That can be very nice. If you have chances of loss of money, then why don't you regularly donate money in some particular situations to some particular people? For example, if you have to donate money for son, for example, your son is in very bad condition, why don't you fast on Sundays, or at least eat vegetarian food on Sundays, avoid sexual relations on Sundays, and donate some money to organizations who look for blind people. Similarly, all the planets, all the nine planets that are used in Vedic astrology, they have very specific remedial measures mentioned in the ancient texts. Of course, you know it's a very ancient subject, Vedic astrology, as old as the Vedas. So it's very interesting. You can easily come for a consultation if you want, and know your spiritual responsibilities, the mission of life, why you have come here, what you will have to accept, what you can give to people, which people can benefit from. So all these things, my friends. So if you want, you can definitely approach any good experienced Vedic astrologer for a very interesting material plus spiritual consultation, along with the spiritual and material remedies. Material remedies in the forms of minerals, in the forms of let's say metals, like these things. Spiritual remedies in the form of charities, mantras, yajnas, several kinds of things are possible. So my friends, hope to see you soon. You can also come and join in the classes that I'll be having in the different countries. So you can easily come here to Belarus, to Lithuania, to Latvia, to Estonia, to Poland, to Bulgaria. You can easily contact me, contact my organizers in your countries. And you can have the courses also. Some basic knowledge on Vedic astrology can be very good. And maybe in future you will give consultations like me in different countries. So, hope to see you in consultations or courses very soon. My trip will be from 24th September to 12th December this time. I hope to meet a lot of new friends, because I think my clients and students are firstly my friends. I love them. I want them to be successful, to be happy. I don't act really like a guru or a teacher. I act more like a friend, and I like to be like that. So, hope to see you soon, my friends. Goodbye from New Delhi, from Professor Arjun Chakraborty. See you soon. Bye.